James Elder, IFL TV, in association with MTK Global. We're in New York City with me, looking very trim today. I've got Pomona.
It's the haircut. It's just the haircut.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, it's just the haircut. You know, listen, you know that trick. What are you talking about? We're currently on Madison, I think. Well, just off Madison by the Mendes gym. We're outside and everyone is looking, thinking, what is going on here? No one knows who I am. She's fantastic.
Do you like it like that?
Much better. Listen, you could never, what I do, I have to be eternally blessed for the opportunities that I have. But it is nice to walk down the street without people looking at you going, who that boxing geezer, aren't you? Barry Earn.
Let's talk a little bit about the card. Danny Jacobs, great to see him back in action. Last saw him out when he fought Golovkin in Madison Square Garden. Tough young sort of contender, if you like.
Well, you saw him down there. I mean, this is a real potential banana skin, this fight. This is a guy that come through the Mayweather setup, signed with Rock Nation. I think he's 18-0, 19-0, coming off a real good win on the Kovalev Ward card. But more importantly, fancies it. You know, it's not just the guys, like, he fancies it. He says he's going to go to war with Jacobs, and you know, I believe Jacobs is the best middleweight in the world, or the top two, or if you want to be obnoxious, the top three. So he should be showing his levels against Arias, but new promoter, new network, you know, a lot of attention on his fight, so he'll be looking to make a statement on Saturday in a really good middleweight fight.
We'll come back to Jacobs a little bit. Also on the card, Big Baby Miller.
Your new favourite.
Someone who's very charismatic.
Yeah, and looks in great shape as well. Yeah, I watched his Washington fight and he was carrying a bit too much weight. Still a good win, but he looks in great shape. And by the way, you know, you said to me up the stairs, I don't know if Miller knows how much of a tough fight he's in against Marius Wack. This is a proper heavyweight matchup. Marius Wack, he's a great fighter. He's in most top 15s, in some top 10s in world boxing. So, Baby Miller, if he can beat Marius Wack, he can start calling out for world championships. You know, and talk about the Wilder fight and stuff like that. Miller against Joshua in the US is a great fight for us to launch on as well. So, I really like Big Baby Miller. He can fight, he looks the part, he talks great. So, but we'll see how good he is when he fights Marius Wack, because Wolczek and the Polish boys just told me it's a KO inside six.
They're very confident.
They are. They've got the camouflage jackets on. They say they're here for war.
They are some very serious jackets Team Wack are wearing.
Like those trousers.
Got to say, very, very...
Check them out.
Team Wack trousers. Now, the big stories this week, it's been involving Anthony Joshua, Shane Finkel, the news regarding Deontay Wilder, can the fight potentially happen? Is there anything or any light you can shed on that situation?
No, listen, Deontay's doing a great job to, you know, use Anthony's name to raise the profile of the fight, and he's doing a great job. Fans have got to understand, when he talks about Anthony Joshua running from this fight, I don't know how long he is suggesting that Anthony's been running. They both had a mandatory they had to deal with, and the fight, they've started talking about the fight from Sunday. So has Anthony Joshua been running for all of two or three days, then perhaps. AJ sat in a meeting with me yesterday and he said, have they made us an offer or something? I said, no. Have they reached out to you? I said, no. He said, then what's it all about? I said, look, it's just a game. So I said, what do you want me to do? He said, go and have a meeting with them, find out what they want, see if we can make the fight for 2018. Phoned up Shelley Finkel, got the meeting tomorrow with him and Al Heyman. See if there's any substance to it. Do they really want the fight next? Do they want it in the summer? Do they want it in the fall? It has to happen in 2018, no question. And it's going to get bigger and bigger and bigger, but we also have to listen to fans. You can't get away with just delaying fights anymore, because every time you wake up, there's a million tweets saying, if you don't make the Wilder-Joshua fight, Hearn, you're a prick. So obviously, you want to try and deliver. But also, you've got to do the right job for the fighters. And until we sit down, until we find out the substance, we have no idea if it's possible or not. What you have to do, unfortunately, what Anthony has to do, is overpay opponents. And he's been doing it his whole career. Now, probably the last Anthony Joshua opponent, probably his purse wasn't dissimilar to Deontay Wilder's purse. Anthony's earning, what, eight times as much. But if we offered Deontay Wilder the correct purse for this fight, it would never ever happen, because he would think it was disrespectful. So we have to overpay him to try and make the fight. And we've got to give him respect and credit. He's a great fighter, he's a great champion. He's really exciting. His profile's beginning to rise here in the States because he's a great self-promoter. I feel a bit bad for him. He's got no promoter pushing him. And like, he's having to phone up chat shows himself, just like randomly going, it's Deontay Wilder, you might have heard of me, I'm the heavyweight champion of the world. Yeah, anyway, where's Joshua running for? Like, for years. It's like, whoa. But he's brilliant at that, and his latest social media thing's great. But you know AJ. Completely the other thing, isn't it? You know, it's like, yeah, I'll fight him. Like, I'm not going to shout and holler. But we want every belt, and to do that, we have to beat Deontay Wilder. So in these negotiations, we're going to have to find a middle ground between reality and fantasy. And if we can do that, I don't see any problems making a fight.
Where does it make the most money in your opinion?
Good question. I mean, I heard Shelly Finkel's comments that, oh, just because you see all these people on TV doesn't mean that's where the most money is. Good point. That's because we price it fairly for fight fans. If it's in Vegas, the cheapest ticket will probably be $250. The cheapest ticket at Wembley is £40. So if we wanted to make a bigger gate at Wembley, we could, but I would also get lynched and have my bollocks kicked in the process by fight fans. So we have to have a look at it. We'd like to fight in the UK, Deontay would like to fight in America, wherever it makes most sense. Maybe we do one fight in England, one fight in America. But again, until we sit down tomorrow, like, there's never ever been a conversation about this fight. And these fights aren't fights that just get made after one meeting. So now we have to start the process. Good news for fight fans is the process is underway. I think unquestionably the biggest fight in world boxing. You know, I want to be involved in the biggest fight in world boxing. AJ wants to be involved in the biggest fight in world boxing. So if it's not Wilder, who's it going to be? Maybe Parker. We've opened negotiations with her team as well. And then we go from there.
Let's talk a little bit about Tyson Fury.
Yes.
Situation, potentially we saw a couple of weeks ago you saying that you would love to work with Tyson Fury. We know he came over to Monaco, it's been well documented. What's the sort of outcome with that situation?
Oh, more of a social really for him. Bit of chat, but not really in terms of necessarily working together and doing deals. But, you know, I think that if he wants the Anthony Joshua fight, he knows where to come. But forget the Anthony Joshua fight for now for Tyson. Get him back on the horse. You know, get him in big fights, get him up there in the rankings, get him, let the public believe the words and the hype again, rather than just listening to it on social media, you know? Because he's a great fighter, he's a good guy, but too many people, too many times have heard, I'm coming back, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. Let's show them the actions. I know with fighters that if they have a plan, if you give them the respect, if you give them the backing, if you show them the strategy, they will be motivated. If you don't, if they don't know what they're doing, if the team around them's not good enough, if there's no direction or buzz, it's very easy to get disheartened. And what Tyson needs is a strategy, a plan. Get back in the gym, you're fighting then, blah, blah, blah. Obviously the UK stuff's got to sort itself out, but whether we work together or not, I hope so. Of course, that's the way to make the Anthony Joshua fight. And again, you know, this Wilder thing's really taken off over the last couple of days. But for me, the Fury fight is still the one I want to see. But the Wilder fight is still an immense fight. So the good news is for AJ is he's got all these super fights on the horizon. But we have to get AJ back on a horse. Tyson.
What's the beef with Lou DiBella? And has he got any interest in negotiations with the Deontay Wilder?
Listen, Lou called me yesterday. He's like, oh, I know you're going to be around the US media all week, you know. No low blows, please. I said, oh, well, that's great. You coated me off for 2 weeks, and now you expect me to be nice. I've known Lou since I was 8 or 9 years old. He's a very hot-headed, you know, his power in boxing has been up here, it's been down here, and it's somewhere, like, I don't know, in the middle at the moment. He doesn't have any involvement with Deontay Wilder in terms of negotiating his fights. Lou DiBella promotes the shows that Deontay Wilder boxes on. So, yeah, that's about it really. I mean, I'm not gonna slate him. Maybe I'll do that later in the week. But for now, after he made a nice phone call to me, I feel a bit guilty. So all I'm gonna say now is, he has no involvement in the discussions and negotiations with Deontay Wilder. Whether he's involved in the show as a promoter on behalf of somebody else, quite possibly, but I shouldn't disrespect people who have been in the boxing game for so long. And, you know, whilst clearly not as good as me, you know, have been around a long time.
Rather grown up with you, rather grown up.
Yeah, just because I'm an American.
Two potential fights, like, I think you may like. Dillian White, Baby Miller, can that happen?
Yes, I like that fight. That's a fight that might get ordered by the IBF as a final eliminator. Also like, I like Dillian White against Lucas Brown as well. It's a fight we're looking at as well. Dillian's going to box on February the 3rd at the O2, so you know, we want to make a big fight for that. What was the other fight you liked?
The other fight I like is Daniel Jacobs beat Andy Lee.
Good fight. That's been kind of discussed with Adam Booth. The plan with Danny, all being well on Saturday, is to fight the winner of Lemieux against Saunders in the States. I fancy in that fight. I think Billy Joe, I'd like Lemieux to win for the business of Danny Jacobs, but my heart would like to see Billy Joe do it, so hopefully he gets the job done.
Ruthless.
Yeah, that's the truth, just being honest with you.
I like that.
It's a good fight, and then, you know, obviously fighting the winner of Canelo against Golovkin. But if the rematch doesn't get made, I said to Tom Loffler in Monaco last week, Danny Jacobs is ready to go if Canelo doesn't want to fight Golovkin.
Such a great story, Danny Jacobs.
He's great story.
Come sort of.
Have you ever interviewed him before?
I think I've interviewed him once.
Great guy, great athlete, great story. You know, I think that one of the guys in the media says, you know, how long do you think you can dine out on the story of Daniel Jacobs overcoming cancer, being told he'll never walk or box again? And I said, forever. Because no one's ever, you know, not everyone's heard the story. So, you know.
To be fair, that man probably didn't overcome cancer and learn to walk.
No, but you know, I mean, the problem in America is fighters don't have any real profile on the streets. Do you know what I mean? Like, if you went down the street in England and said, do you know who Anthony Joshua is? How many times out of 10 would someone say, yeah, he's X? 10 out of 10? Maybe 9 out of 10? You know, here, I mean, look, I know this guy. How you doing, mate?
Nice to meet you.
I've never met you before, right?
No, my name's Dream.
Do you know who Deontay Wilder is?
No, who's that?
Okay, no problem. That was just a quiz we're playing. Oh, thank you, bro. Thanks, take care. That's a classic example. You know what I mean? We can do it all day long, and I don't think anyone's
there. Do one more.
Okay.
Well, excuse me.
Just a. Do you know who Deontay Wilder is?
Deon who?
Deontay Wilder.
An NFL player?
No, not quite, but good effort. Thank you, sir. Have a great day. So here we are. You know, we're out on the streets in New York, and it's quite simple. You know, this is the problem. You have to hit the man on the street. You have to hit the general public. If I was promoting the world heavyweight champion from America who could fight like Deontay Wilder could, who could talk like Deontay Wilder could, who walks and looks like Deontay Wilder would, every time someone walked past, the question and the answer would be different. Yes, Luis Arias. What's happening?
What's happening, Luis?
You alright, mate?
Yeah, you alright?
Hey. This man means business on Saturday.
Hey, you see that smile?
I'll tell you what, I watched him on the pads. I'm a little bit scared.
I saw you watching. I know you was watching.
Yeah, so there you go. Says it all, really, doesn't it?
Says it all.
How do we make this fight a fight that we need to come back here? And the moment we can come back here and walk down here and say, do you know who Deontay Wilder is? Of course I know Deontay Wilder. He's the world heavyweight champion. Well, by the way, AJ's profile needs a lot of work here still. It's not like, but at least in Britain, he couldn't, I mean, I don't think there's anyone. You ask that to anyone, what the answer would have been. So, we hope to make that fight in 2018. Whether it's next or not, I don't know. But as always, I'll keep you in the loop and I'll keep you up to speed.
Eddie Hearn, thank you very much for giving me some time today. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon and I'll catch you soon.
Cheers, mate.